रेतवार मन की बात प्रोग्रामस मज 28 मार्च सुबह कहि बजे पन ख्याल अमे पत यी मन की बात प्रोग्राम अलाकई जबानन मज तर्जम आकाशवाणी तो दूरदर्शन क्यों सारव स्टेशनों पे नशर करना। मन की बात प्रोग्राम अलाकई जबानन मज तर्जम यी दोबारा रात हज 8 बजे आकाशवाणी तो दूरदर्शन क्यों सारव स्टेशनों पे नशर करना। याद थयु आथवार 28 मार्च सुबह कहि बजे मन की बात।
Hello and welcome to Kashmir Now. I'm your host Shreya Sabijay. Let's take a look at some stories of this week's episode. Protests against load shedding continue to draw off illegally occupied Gilgit-Baltistan. Electricity department employees protest in illegally occupied POK demand technical allowance. Indian Army provides free tuition classes to poor students in Baramulla. Horticulture Department organizes a training camp for women in Udhampur to ensure their self-reliance. And later, we'll take you to experience the beauty of nature in a special edition of Incredible India. Protests against load shedding have gained intensity across illegally occupied Gilgit-Baltistan. People are constantly urging the government to look into this issue, as 20 hours of power cut has merely disrupted their lives in this bone-chilling winter. Though the government had promised uninterrupted supply of electricity to the people, but never paid heed to their needs after coming to power. Fully covered in warm clothes, thousands of people across illegally occupied Gilgit-Baltistan came out on roads in this harsh winter season to highlight the issue of prolonged load shedding, which has created havoc in their lives. While a large part of the region receives just 5 to 6 hours of electricity in a day, remaining does not get even that. Amid the protest, demonstrators shouted slogans against the administration, burnt tires and blocked the main highway to force the government to take immediate action on it, as earlier it has just given them false hopes but has done nothing in reality.
एक महीने से हमारे साथ बिल्कुल बिजली हमारे कोनोदास एरियाज नगर कॉलोनी सरकार कॉलोनी में बिजली बिल्कुल ही नहीं है ना। उसी बिजली के बिना पे हमें पानी से हम महरूम है। हमारे घर से हमारे माए हमारी बहनें दरिया जाती हैं, वहां से पानी लाना में बहुत मुश्किलात होती हैं। उसी हवाले से हमने एक 10 दिन पहले भी एक धरना दिया था पुल के ऊपर, आरसीसी पुल के ऊपर, वहां पे यही अमला आ गई। उन्होंने हमें यकीन दहानी कराई कि आपका मसला हल होगा बहुत जल्द। उसके बाद आज ये 10-15 दिन हुए, अभी तक हमारे मुतालबात हल नहीं हुए, हमें बहालत मजबूरन रोड पे निकलना पड़ा।
Gilgit-Baltistan, a region under Pakistan's illegal occupation, is among the top regions in the world with maximum electricity generation potential. Home to some giant soaring rivers and gigantic glaciers, the region is blessed with abundance of water resources, thus making it a suitable destination for hydropower generation projects. However, due to absence of a political will, deep-rooted corruption and systematic discrimination by the authorities, the residents are deprived of proper supply of electricity. The available sources of power cater mostly to the people of Pakistan and not the region, and thus they have to demonstrate again and again to demand something that already belongs to them. Fed up with this apathetic attitude of the administration, the demonstrators in Yasim area of Khizer district said that we won't let electricity supply to other areas without fulfilling our needs.
स्टेशन को बता देना चाहता हूं कि जब तक बिजली यासीन के लोगों की जरूरियात मुकम्मल करने के बगैर कहीं भी दोगे हम तुम्हें करने नहीं देंगे।
Most of Gilgit-Baltistan's electricity revenue is exhausted as salaries and perks to the Pakistani officials, and a minuscule of it is allotted for the development of the ongoing projects. Authorities use cheap and outdated machinery along with substandard material that leads to the downfall of the efficiency of the power plants. Residents complain that the electricity crisis is deepening day by day, as it is not only affecting their day-to-day lives but also their health and employment. Moving on, be it providing basic amenities to its people or fulfilling their rightful demands, the government of illegally occupied POK, which works in cahoots with Islamabad, has always lagged behind. It is only concerned with filling its own coffers rather than doing something for the betterment of its people. As a result, time and again, people have to come on the streets to demand their rights. Recently, the employees of electricity department in the region held a demonstration to demand technical allowance. We have a report.
The employees of electricity department in illegally occupied POK recently organized protest to demand technical allowance, which they say is being deliberately denied to them by the administration. They also issued an ultimatum saying that they would go for a hunger strike if government didn't pay an immediate heed to their demands. Electricians say that there is not even a single demand of ours which the government cannot fulfill, but even then it is testing our patience.
हमारे हाल पर विराम करें और हमारे जायज मुतालबात जो चार्टर ऑफ डिमांड में दिए गए हैं इनमें एक से एक मुतालबा भी ऐसा नहीं है जो इनके बस से बाहर हो या पूरा ना कर सकते हो। मैं बल्कियात के आला अफिसरान को जोर अपील करता हूँ कि हमारे दिए गए चार्टर ऑफ डिमांड में जो भी मुतालबात हैं उनको फिल फोर पूरा किया जाए, अदरवाइज हम यहाँ से उस वक्त तक नहीं उठेंगे जब तक हमारे मुतालबात पूरे नहीं होते और हम ताज हमें मर्ज भूख और तार की काल भी दे सकते हैं। इससे चूँकि तंग आमन बजंग आमन तो हमारे सबर का पैमाना लबरेज हो चुका है और हमारे सबर को और मजीद ना आजमाया जाए।
पाकिस्तान विच क्लेम्स द रीजन ऑफ इट्स ओन has given similar allowances to technical workers in its provinces, but has turned a blind eye to the demands of those working in its illegally occupied territory. All they are asking for years is a revenue of 8 crore rupees as a technical allowance that will be provided to all the employees of the electricity department in the region, but the POK government that works in cahoots with Islamabad seems to be least concerned.
जी सर की सच्ची मालियात से यह मुतबाना अल्तमास करता हूँ कि खुदा रहा हम आपके बच्चों की जगह है। अगर आपके लिए एग्जेक्टिव अलाउंस हो सकता है, आईजीपी के लिए 2 लाख का अलाउंस हो सकता है पर मंथ, और हम आए कई सालों से हड़तालें कर रहे हैं और कह रहे हैं कि हमें ये बुनियादी चीज दे दें। हमारे लोग परेशान हाल हैं, उनके छोटे छोटे बच्चे, वो कोई लोग एक ही ग्रेड में रिटायर होकर यहाँ से महकमे से जा रहे हैं, तो हमारा कोई परेशान हाल नहीं है। हमारे लिए कानून तो होना चाहिए था, स्टेट के अंदर जो अलाउंस होना चाहिए था वो निजामतों को भी अंदर आते, लेकिन हमें वो अलाउंस नहीं मिला। हमें जो डेंजर अलाउंस दिया गया वो वापस में 7,000 रुपए, लेकिन यहाँ पे जो हमें डेंजर अलाउंस मिला वो मिला 2,500, 3,000 और 4,000 रुपए। और सुतम जरीफी की बात ये कि ये तो करवाया था हमने ग्रेड 1 से लेकर 16 तक के लिए कि चलो सारे लोगों को मिल जाएगा, उसमें मीटर रीडर्स को भी मिल जाएगा, उसमें लाइनमैन को भी मिलेगा, असिस्टेंट लाइनमैन को भी मिलेगा, लेकिन अफसोस से कहना पड़ रहा है कि वो अलाउंस जो है वो सिर्फ 3 कैडर को मिला और बाकियों को नहीं मिला।
इट इज नॉट जस्ट अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रिशियंस। Pakistan has systematically denied benefits, rights and resources to the people of this illegally occupied territory for more than 7 decades. Demands and dissents have been suppressed using excessive force, and in some cases even a legislative route has been used to keep them marginalized and deprived.
Next, we move to Jammu and Kashmir, where from conducting awareness camps and seminars to distribution of medicines and ration, the Indian Army has been trying its level best to cater to the needs of the citizens. Presently, as the territory is wrapped in a blanket of chilly winters, the Army is organizing free coaching classes for underprivileged students in its Baramulla district. Take a look.
Education is not a privilege but a basic right of all. All children, regardless of their caste, creed, gender or social status, have the right to get access to education. In order to help the meritorious students who come from families below the poverty line, the Ningli Army Camp of Uplona Rashtriya Rifles Battalion has started giving them free of cost tuition classes in Baramulla district of Northern Kashmir.
मैं असरुल हक अपने और सारे बच्चों की तरफ से 52RR का तहे दिल से शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ, जिन्होंने हमारे लिए मुफ्त के सरमाए कोचिंग क्लासेस फराहम किए, जिनमें COVID-19 के सभी SOPs का ख्याल रखा गया है, जैसे कि मास्क, सैनिटाइजर्स और सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग का भी ख्याल रखा गया है, और यहाँ पे हीटिंग अरेंजमेंट भी है और हमारा स्टाफ भी बहुत अच्छा है।
कंडक्टेड फॉर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ 9th ग्रेड, द क्लासेस एम टू ब्रिज द गैप इन एकेडमिक लर्निंग क्रिएटेड ड्यू टू द COVID-19 पेंडेमिक एंड प्रिपेयर देम फॉर देयर फ्यूचर एग्जामिनेशंस। Being held at a government middle school in Tarzu area of Baramulla's Supur town, a total of 50 students, which include 30 girls and 20 boys from nearby villages, are attending these coaching classes. Five local teachers having vast experience in the field have been selected to teach all mandatory subjects including English, social science, mathematics, science and Urdu.
सबसे पहले मैं 52RR का तहे दिल से शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ, जिन्होंने यहाँ पे 50 से 60 गरीब बच्चों के लिए मुफ्त सरमाई कोचिंग फराहम की है। इस कोचिंग सेंटर में मजीद 5 ऐसे उस्तादीजा साहिबान काम कर रहे हैं जो हाई क्वालिफाइड है। इस बात पर हम दोबारा 52RR का शुक्रिया अदा करते हैं, जिन्होंने हम बेरोजगार उस्तादीजा साहिबान को साल भर कॉन्ट्रेक्चुअल बेसिस पे काम करते हैं इनको रोजगार फराहम किया।
Free stationery is also provided to the students in these coaching classes. Army officials have ensured that all COVID-19 precautions, including daily temperature screening, provision of face masks, hand sanitizers, are being undertaken in these classrooms. Apart from that, heaters have also been kept for regular fumigation of the classrooms to help these students in fighting the chilly winters. The youngsters are happy to avail such facilities while keeping themselves afloat with their studies amid the pandemic.
मैं अपने और सारे बच्चों की तरफ से इंडियन आर्मी का शुक्रिया अदा करती हूं कि उन्होंने यहां पर फ्री कोचिंग क्लासेस रखे हैं। इस कोचिंग सेंटर में कोविड-19 के तमाम एसओपीएस का ख्याल रखा है, जिनमें सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग, यूजिंग ऑफ सैनिटाइजर्स, मास्क सरफरस्त हैं। इसके अलावा इन्होंने हीटिंग का भी इंतजाम यहाँ पर रखा है।
This novel initiative will not just help in bridging the learning gap among the students with poor financial background, but also propel them towards a brighter and promising future. Alongside, it will go a long way in strengthening the bond of mutual respect, friendship, and understanding between the general public and the armed forces.
It is rightly said that there is no tool for development more effective than the empowerment of women. If a society wants to prosper, then it should focus on making its women both stronger and self-reliant. Moving ahead in the same direction, the Horticulture Department of Jammu and Kashmir has organized a month-long training program for women in Udhampur, wherein they are taught the art of fruit and vegetable processing, using which they can earn a livelihood for themselves. Have a look.
How to chop off the lemon and extract its juice. What is the right proportion of salt, turmeric and sugar you need to add, and many more questions like these were answered during the 30-day training program held in Udhampur. Beet tomato puree, apple juice, jams, jellies, squashes, pickles or many more things that can be made by processing of fruits and vegetables were taught to women living in the far-flung areas. Organized by the Horticulture Department of Jammu and Kashmir in almost every panchayat of Udhampur district, the program aimed towards 0% wastage of fruits and vegetables, along with giving boost to women empowerment.
हमने इस बार जो उधमपुर के लिए हैं, खासकर महिलाओं के लिए, हर पंचायत में हम एक-एक कैंप इस वक्त जो है वो करने जा रहे हैं, खासकर वैल्यू एडिशन के लिए, ताकि हमारी महिलाएं जो हैं खुद से सक्षम हों, चाहे वो जितना भी हमारा कोई 25-30% जो हमारा फ्रूट जो था वो वेस्ट अदरवाइज होता था, तो उस वेस्टेज को हम जीरो वेस्ट, मतलब हमारा जो कमिटमेंट है डिपार्टमेंट का ये है कि 0% वेस्टेज, तो 0% वेस्टेज तो पहुंचाने तक हम चाहते हैं कि हर एक पंचायत तक हमारे जो हैं जो ऑफिसरान हैं, हमारे जो टेक्नीशियन हैं, ये पहुंच रहे हैं और हर जगह जो है वो कैंप हम लगा रहे हैं।
Besides learning the production method, trainees were also given detailed lectures by the experts on how to increase the shelf life and market their products. After the completion of the training, an appreciation certificate will be issued to the trainees, who can then establish their own units and earn a livelihood for themselves as well as for their family.
यहाँ पे आज हॉर्टिकल्चर के द्वारा यहाँ पे कैंप लगाया गया है, जिसमें कि बताया गया कि कैसे पिकल्स बनाने हैं, जैम्स की रेसिपीज वगैरह बताई हैं, जिससे कि हमारी लेडीज को बहुत ही बेनिफिट होने वाला है, जिससे वो आगे जाके अपना खुद का एक स्कीम, खुद का एक कैंप शुरू कर सकती हैं, जिससे कि वो एम्प्लॉयड हो सकती हैं। जो अनएम्प्लॉयड लेडीज हैं, जहाँ पे ज्यादातर अनएम्प्लॉयड हैं, सब हाउस वाइफ हैं, वो सब अपना अपना काम शुरू कर सकती हैं, जिससे कि सब लेडीज को बहुत ज्यादा फायदा होने वाला है। वो अपनी खुद अपने पैरों पे खड़ी हो सकती हैं और अपना जो उनका मन करे वो कर सकती हैं वो।
Sushma Rani, an owner of a micro food processing unit named the Green Himalaya Group in Chennai area of Udhampur, is one among those who had first received the training provided by the horticulture department and then set up their own unit. She established it under Mission for Integrated Development of Horticulture, a centrally sponsored scheme for the holistic growth of the horticulture sector. And today, on an average, her unit makes around rupees 4,000 to rupees 5,000 per day.
ये 2018 में शुरू किया था। 17 में हमने ट्रेनिंग की थी लुधियाना इधर चनैनी में, तो ये भी हॉर्टिकल्चर वालों ने दी थी। तो फिर उसके बाद एक हफ्ता के लिए ये हमें लेके गए थे लुधियाना में, उधर भी ट्रेनिंग की एक हफ्ता। तो उसके बाद हमने ये काम शुरू कर दिया था। मेरे साथ 5 लेडीज और भी हैं, वो भी काम करती थी मेरे साथ। प्रधानमंत्री जी बोलते हैं कि आत्मनिर्भर भारत, तो आत्मनिर्भर भारत ऐसे थोड़े बनेगा, हम खुद भी काम करेंगे तो तभी होगा ना। काम करो, आगे बढ़ो। मैं तो सभी को ये बोलती हूँ कि खुद काम करो। जो सपोर्ट हमारी हॉर्टिकल्चर वाले कर रहे हैं वो कोई भी नहीं करेगा। 1 लाख रुपया इन्होंने हमें सब्सिडी दी है, बाकी जो भी जिस वक्त भी इनका कोई हेल्प की जरूरत पड़ती है तो हमारे साथ रहते हैं जी भी।
Women are the building blocks of a society, and if they are empowered, the whole society gets benefited. Therefore, it is a great initiative by the Horticulture Department of the Union Territory to make women skilled and financially independent.
Next, we move to our section of Incredible India, where today we'll take you to visit the beautiful log huts situated in the Tapania Eco Park of Tripura's capital, Agartala. Reopened after months of shutdown imposed due to COVID-19, these huts can provide tourists with a wonderful opportunity to rejuvenate and explore the essence of nature.
47 kilometers away from capital city Agartala, amidst soothing sounds of birds and freshly bloomed green leaves, nestles little log huts in Tapania Eco Park. Constructed by Tripura Tourism Development Corporation, these log huts have been opened again for the tourists after 6 months shutdown due to COVID-infused lockdown.
Staying in the log huts, staying close to the nature after a long time after the pandemic, when we all were locked inside, and after that coming out and seeing this and experiencing, it's quite amazing. And this place, I believe, has huge potential for the tourists to come and explore.
The huts are blended with natural ambience and are fully equipped with all the modern facilities, which include a bonfire, dining room and picnic spots. Besides staying at the log huts, the early morning walk on the wooden path, lying in the middle of green canopy and bamboo groves, is no less than a dreamlike experience.
Just now at Tapania Eco Park, which is at Udaipur. It is a great place for outing. I came with my friends and family to have some gathering. We have some outing here, over here. At this year ending, it is very safe to come here. It is in the jungle, apart from the huge crowd gathering of the city. आई एम वेरी मच फीलिंग वेरी कम्फर्ट हियर एंड आई एम वेरी मच हैप्पी टू कम हियर.
It is a lifetime experience staying in the wooden rooms here with the warm hospitality of the members of the Joint Forest Management Committee who shares 40% of the revenue earned from the huts with the Tripura Tourism Development Corporation.
आपको जानने के बाद आप खुशी होंगे जब टेपनिया इको पार्क में जो लॉकेट आप लोग चालू किया, चालू करने के बाद जब कोविड 19 के टूरिस्ट के लिए बैंड लग गया उसका पहले तो कभी खाली नहीं रहती. बहुत अच्छा उसमें पोजीशन परिवेश एंड टोटली फॉरेस्ट एरिया घेरा उसमें बहुत अच्छा लगते हैं. आदमी लोग आना शुरू कर दिया तो इसके बाद हम लोग आगे बरमुरा भी किया था लेकिन चालू अभी तक हुआ नहीं. सिपाही जलों में कर दिया पहले अक्टूबर में तो उसको लिए भी हम लोग कभी चालू करने जा रहे हैं. चालू हो गया लेकिन टूरिस्ट अभी आना शुरू नहीं हुआ.
The northeastern state of Tripura is abundant with lush green grounds, tall trees and dense forests. Visitors from not just India but all around the world flock the state to enjoy its picturesque beauty. Few of the major nature attractions in the state include Unakoti, a town in Tripura which is famous for its marvelous rock carvings, murals with their primitive beauty and waterfalls. Every year, a fair called Ashokashtami Mela is organized in the month of April which is flocked by tourists from the near and far. Another hot spot on the list is the Heritage Park in Agartala. Spread over 12 acres of land, the park is located at the center of the city. It is divided into three segments: Mini Tripura, which covers about 3 acres of land at the entrance, Central Areas, which is raised as a natural forest, and a plain tableland with medicinal plants, herbs and shrubs. Sipahi Jala Wildlife Sanctuary is one more attraction to seek solace in the lap of nature. It is woodland with an artificial lake and natural botanical and zoological gardens. Famous for clouded leopard enclosures, the sanctuary is home to about 150 species of birds. With such tourist attractions in its abode, Tripura is definitely a must-visit place once in a lifetime.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a hub of number of tourist spots that we'll continue to explore in a section of Incredible India. So that's all we have for you in this week's episode. Till we see you next week, it's goodbye from the entire production team.
A global pandemic that's causing havoc worldwide. Face mask has been found to be the most effective means to fight the spread of COVID-19. World Health Organization and various researchers have also found that masks are critical in mitigating the spread of COVID-19. When you wear a mask, you protect yourself and people around you. Be a part of Mask Up India campaign.